Feel like giving God the glory. Give all the glory. Give all the glory. Church, I feel like giving God the glory. For he has been so good. You know I feel like
has been so good. Amen. Hallelujah. He's been so good. I feel like giving God the glory. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. I feel like giving God the glory. Do you feel like giving God the glory today? Amen. This is a new day that he's given us. New mercies, new blessings. Hallelujah. We thank God to be able just to see and talk to you today. Amen. God is a wonderful God. He's kept us all week, all month, and we're going into a new season, a new year. Amen. We actually coming up with a blessing, amen, this month. Amen. The birth of Christ. Hallelujah. God sent a Savior to the world, a King of Kings and a Lord of Lords. Amen. For us, even right now, we wasn't born back then, but look at what we accomplished. Look at what we have right now because of what God sent into this world. Amen. His only begotten Son. Hallelujah, that whosoever believe in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Hallelujah. We believe in him tonight. Amen. We want to welcome you again to the TMA Radio Show. I'm your host, Pastor Ackridge, and we are just kicking up, getting started with one of our locals, Somnus, amen, soloist, Crystal Davis, hallelujah, singing. I feel like giving God the glory. I feel like giving him some praise today. I don't know about you, but I just thank him because if it had not been, I probably lost my mind. I probably done something crazy, but because he had a strain on me, because he had a hold on me, he didn't let me get too far out there while I was crazy and messing up. But I thank God for now my change. I thank him now for watching over me in the midst of the all that I was doing and all I was going through. I thank God, and he's going to continue to touch and do a mighty work in me. I just know he is, and I just thank him for just thinking enough about me then for my right now moments. Hallelujah. We praise God for all you listeners that continue to tune in each and every week. We got the third Sunday, Our Power with the Word, coming up this third Sunday at 7 o'clock. And we're going to be reaching out to a pastor, a friend of mine, and hopefully we can get in contact with them and that they can come on, because we know that God is able. Amen. Somebody might need a word on an evening service, because that might have worked all day. But anytime, even if you have had a service, you never can get enough word. You can never get enough teaching. I don't care who you are or where you are, we cannot get enough teaching and enough preaching. Amen. We might need it all day long, 24/7. Amen. But we thank and praise God for you and your family. And this is the season that we are just so thankful to God for his son. Amen. Born into a world of a Virgin Mary. Hallelujah. And people want to know, how in the world can this woman get pregnant without a man? Well, if you remember that God spoke and things happened, things came into existence. Hallelujah. He did so much in the creation of this world, and all he had to do was speak. Hallelujah. And things was. So therefore, God can do whatever he chooses. Amen. Because he's God, and there is none other than him. Amen. We'll be right back with more. We got the weather coming up. And what will we do at questioning? I put that on there, added to the show tonight. What will we do at questioning? And we're talking in the spiritual, when people come and ask you whose you are, who do you believe? Even if your life depend on it, what are you going to say at questioning? You going to fold up like Peter, or are we going to stand and say we are the children of the King, and he is the King of Kings, Lord of Lords, and by his name, by his sound, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess? Will we stand, or will we act like we don't know him if danger really comes? And I'm going to read some to you just a little while in the show, so we'll be right back with more.
Yo, these streets is watching and they need no binoculars to see imposters. The streets need gospel and faith where blind, sick, possessed, and dead rise. And mass murder does nothing for the paralyzed. But yo, his army is different. It transforms lives. So first the lame walk and then the lame ride. And when the lame talk, that's when his name fly. Even in places where it's illegal to say God. AK hits the door, they hit the floor, clutching up every book that they searching them for. And even though these refugees ain't seen church, they memorized every verse. This is for the 8-year-old who goes home to the favela, singing psalms under his breath, a cappella. That preteen weeps on the streets of Boston. This the price the crocodile tears lacosted. Nails in a back that was shredded like a cheese grater. These lines bring heat like the equator. And in the street, we ain't fighting what we see, player. Wrestle the air condition, AC Slater.
You have to fix the mind before you can bestow the blessing, because until they get their mind right, everything you invest in them is going to leak out of the crevices of a mind that refuses to change. Look at your neighbor and ask him, do you have a mind to change?
from Angola to South Beach, big like Lebowski. Gonna fly us home, want a window or a aisle seat. Lift two arms to the place where the clouds be. Even if you eating from where Oscar the Grouch be. The good news is he's coming real soon. And if your stomach aches, then he's coming with food. And if your heart breaks, then he's coming with tools. And if you have faith, then he's coming for you. Yeah, he's coming for you. And if your life's gray, then he's coming with hues. Rose from the grave for these colorblind fools. Poured out his red and it covered our blues. And here's some more good news, that the situation changes when your mind renews. Here's the time to choose, red or the blue, win or the lose, awake or the snooze.
The street gospel. The streets need gospel.
Wait for an answer. If they said no, drag them to the altar. Tell them they got till midnight to get that fix. Lay your hands on your head and say, give
me. Right, your weather forecast tonight. Chance of rain and showers, low of 43 degrees. Tuesday, rain, high of 48 with a low of 40. Wednesday, mostly clear, high of 58 with a low of 43 degrees. And that's your two-day-and-a-half forecast. Amen, amen.
Oh,
Amen. The Lord keep on blessing me right now, right now. Amen. Amen. We're just talking tonight about what will we do at questioning. And we're talking about when trouble come your way, people ask you and I'm talking in a spiritual sense, what will you do when they ask you, who do you believe in? If you believe, they come to you and ask you, hey, do you believe in God and his son, Jesus Christ? And your life depend on it. What will we say at questioning? How will we answer when our life is in danger? Someone want to kill us because we believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God. If that come to pass, if that wherever in the scenario, what would we do? What would we do at questioning? What we stand, amen, on what we believe? Will we deny Christ, or will we say, yes, I believe in him, I trust in him? What will we do at questioning? And here we see some people in the Word. They walked with him. They saw miracles. They saw all these signs and wonders, but they still denied Christ. Matter of fact, there was one that sold him out, and there was another one that denied him. And they walked from city to city. They even rode on the ship, on the boat with him, and they still didn't believe that he was the Son of God, because it ain't no way in the world I can see all these miracles performing, and I can see you do these things, and I'd say I know that you are the Son of God, and I know you are the Christ, and then deny you, and not only that, but sell you out for a piece of silver, couple of coins. But the Word of God in John 18 verse 1, here in the Word of God it says, when Jesus had spoke these words, he went forth with his disciples over to the brook Cedron, and where was a garden, all right, into the which he entered, and his disciples, everybody going in, and Judas also, which betrayed him. And the ones that selling you out, they even follow you down to see what's going to happen. And Judah also, which betrayed him, knew the place, for Jesus oftentimes resorted there with his disciples. Judas then, having received a band of men and officers from the chief priests and Pharisees, cometh there with lanterns and torches and weapons. Then Jesus, therefore, knowing all things that should come upon him, went forth and said unto them, whom seek ye? They answered him, Jesus of Nazareth. Jesus said unto them, I am he. And Judas also, which betrayed him, stood with them. Your sellouts, even with those that come to seek him. You're supposed to be on Jesus' side, but then you on the opposite side. You just sold about. How in the world can you sell out the one that's coming to the world and love you? But here we see that Judas did. He's with the enemy. He on the other side. Says, Judas also, which betrayed him, stood with them. As soon then as he had said unto them, I am he, they went backwards and fell to the ground. Boy, that's just some power right there. They know his power. But then if they had some doubt, they would have grabbed them. They just would have went right then. But it was something about that anointing presence on that they fell back. Amen. They fell back. Hallelujah. Fell back down to the ground. They were scared to death. This one man. Then asked he them again, whom seek ye? And they said, Jesus of Nazareth. Jesus answered, I have told you that I am he. If therefore ye seek me, let these go their way, that the saying might be fulfilled which he spake of them which thou goest me, have I lost none. Then Simon Peter, having a sword, drew it and smote the high priest's servants and cut his right ear off. The servant named Malchus. And then it says here, then Jesus said unto Peter, put the up thy sword into the shaft. The cup which my father has given me, shall I not drink it? If God, my father told me that I gotta drink this cup, brother, then I gotta drink it. It's no escaping. Let's skip on down here to 19. It said, then the high priest then asked Jesus of the disciples of his doctrine. Now they done captured Jesus. They done brought him into the high priest's palace, and now they question him. It says, Jesus answered him, I spake openly to the world. I don't have nothing to hide. I ever taught, even taught in the synagogue and in the temple where the Jews also resort. And in secret have I said nothing. I ain't said nothing in private that I can't say in open. Why askest thou me? Ask them which heard me. They the one heard me. You know I spoke out in the public. You know everybody heard what I said. Why you ain't going to ask me what I said in private? Everybody heard it. Why askest thou me? Ask them which heard me what I said unto them. Behold, they know what I said. Amen. This is why we at the point that we are at, because they all heard what I said. And when he had thus spoken, one of the officers which stood by struck Jesus with the palm of his hand, saying, answer thou the high priest so. And Jesus answered him, if I have spoken evil, bear witness of the evil. But if well, why smotest thou me? And Aeneas had sent him bound to Caiaphas, the high priest. And Simon Peter stood and warned himself. They said, therefore unto me, art not thou also one of his disciples? Is that not one of the disciples? He denied it. Peter stood and he was warming himself while they over there interrogating his master, Jesus. Amen, amen. His follower. He over there warming himself while they over there interrogating our Lord. Why are they doing it? And so Simon Peter stood and warmed himself. They said therefore unto him, aren't thou also one of the disciples? He denied it and said, I am not. My Lord, look at that right there. What will happen when somebody asks you those questions and you deny the Christ, the one that came into this world to die? Would that be such a terrible thing? You know all the signs and wonders. You know the miracles that he's done. You know the love that he's done. And we deny him. How in the world can we deny such a loving, wonderful son that God sent into this world? And Peter done denied him. Over there warming himself. He over there thinking to himself, I got to get warm. I got to think of my lie. I got to go over here and think, you know, what I'm going to do, what I'm going to say. I just going to have to deny him. One of the servants of the high priest, being a kinsman, whose ear Peter cut off, said, did not I see thee in the garden of him? Now here goes the brother that saw him. And then Peter then denied again, and immediately the cock crew. Amen. Immediately the cock crew. Then led they Jesus from Caiaphas and to the hall of judgment, and it was early, and they themselves went not unto the judgment hall, lest they should be defiled. They scared to even go. Didn't they know what power Jesus possessed, healing, bringing the dead back to life? They witnessing all this, and now they scared of these few folk. They were scared. They didn't realize who they had with them. But what would we do? If somebody coming and want to kill you, if you know who Jesus is, if you believe in Christ and you believe in God, what would we do? What would we do at questioning? Will we deny him like Peter? Will we sell him out like Judas? Or will we stand boldly and say, I believe in the Christ of Nazareth. I believe in the Son of God. I believe. Amen. Because whatever happened, my brothers and sisters, amen, even if you look at death, we got to just trust in God. Because guess what? God is going to make sure he's going to repay all the things that's done against his children. Don't you worry about that. Amen. And I tell you right now, if you know where you're going when you leave this place, Amen, amen. That'll make you stand all the bolder. It'll make you stand even when you feel like fear, even when you tremble. But you have to believe in your spirit. Say, well, Lord God, I'm standing here in the midst of death. I'm looking death in the eyes. But God, you said you will never leave me nor forsake me. You said you will make my enemies my footstool. God, I just have to believe in you. If I die, let me die. Because God, I believe in you. And I tell you what. He gonna watch out for you. He gonna look out for you, because even if we die, hallelujah, look at our place in glory. Hallelujah. There's no more dying there. No more sickness there. Hallelujah. No more restless nights there. There's no more pain and agony there. But rejoicing in a God, hallelujah, that created us, hallelujah, that's what we have to look for. So we should have not fear, even though that's a natural thing, but we can stand and say, I believe in Jesus Christ, hallelujah, of Nazareth. I believe in the Son of God. Amen. And tell that devil that's trying to defeat you, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And God, if there's anything that I have not repented for, God, forgive me now. And just look that enemy right in the face. Hallelujah. And whatever it is, whatever it's going to be, it's going to be. Hallelujah. And that's standing firm. Amen. Even in the midst of danger, even in the midst of somebody trying to kill us, we just have to believe in God regardless of how the situation, and ask God, God, if I ever face such, God, give me the strength, God. Give me the strength to endure. Hallelujah. Give me the strength, God, to not give up on you. Hallelujah. Amen. That's what we need to be doing. Don't be like these brothers here denying Christ. Amen. Amen. If you deny the Lord, he's going to deny you in front of his Father. And I don't want to be denied, and you don't want to be denied, so we have to stand. And even if it look rough, we just have to take it. Just have to swallow it. Amen. And say, God, you said you was going to be with me. And just close your eyes, hallelujah, and God, I know that you're going to be with me. And whatever happens, amen, rest assured, God got it in his control. And whatever is to come to pass is going to come to pass, amen. But we just realize that what will we do in answering time when the time for us to make a choice between knowing who Jesus is and believing in God or just giving in because we are in danger. You know, denying God and his son Jesus Christ because we don't want to die. What will happen to us at the end if you deny me, my Lord? That's rough right there. But we got to stand boldly. And we got to, regardless of how it looks, how it may be, we got to stand tall. And we just got to believe in Christ and know that he is our all in all, and know that he will protect us and shield us from all danger. But what will we do? What will we do at questioning? And that is a question that we could ask ourselves. You know, we could say everything, we could shout, we could praise God, we could say we love him, but when the ball is in the court and we looking right at death, will we still love God? Will we still acknowledge Christ and his works and the reason why he was sent into this world? Will we believe to the end, or will we give in to save our own skin? That's a tough thing, because it's easy while no danger is lurking in our face and death is not knocking at the door. It's easy. But what if when it come knocking? What if we looking at it right in our face? Will we deny? Will we deny Christ? And that's a serious thing to think about, brothers and sisters that are listening tonight and everywhere in the world. When death comes, will we deny him like Peter? Or will we sell him out and say, I don't believe in Christ? Sell him out for our life. I tell you right now, That's a thing to think about. Everything easy is fine, but when it really come in your house, when it come at your door, when it's right there looking at you in your face, that's when it get real. That's when all that jumping and all that I believe and all that comes right then at that time, when it's right breathing in your face. That's something serious. You know, it's easy for us to praise God when everything is good, but when the valley experience come, will we still praise Him? When you know all of this stuff that's going on in the world, if we have to partake of some of this stuff, if we have to indulge in some of this stuff that go on, will we stand or will we fold up? What will we do at questioning? We're going to continue. We'll be right back.
Praise you. can't nobody change or rearrange you. Cause you a God who can't change, can't lie. Praising the God of all truth, rejecting all lies. Dwelling in the shadow of the Most High. Been delivered from a path that most die. I'm talking about El Shaddai. The capital G-O-D. Praise is the key to victory, can't you see? Angels up in heaven singing holy, holy, holy. Is the Lamb, the great I am. Jesus Christ, my main man, takes my hand. Says, son, I'm here. There's no need to fear, just praise, cause it's a weapon. When we lift up the name of Jesus, demons gotta start stepping up out of this place. Building myself up in my most holy faith, proclaiming mercy and grace, which kept me alive. When it comes to living water, I died. You just don't understand. Praise is how I survive. To my flesh, I gotta die. Looking up to the sky, let's praise the name of the Most High. Ushering his presence to give some blessing. I'm sick and tired of all the stressing. Everything that have breath, praise his name. Gotta maintain through the rain. Lord, I gotta praise you. Lord, I need to praise you. I gotta praise you. I need to praise you. I love to praise you.
I confess, SOS, I need you daily. Can't lie, say the pain don't faze me. My God, who gon' help these babies?
My.
I've been in the fire so long, I can't get burned no more. I thought you was putting out the flame, but it was rain from the storm. Thoughts over my head, making me stressed all day long. They won't let me rest, S on my chest. I ain't that strong. I need a lifeline right now. 911 won't do. My back's against the wall now. Done all that I could do. I prayed every prayer, went to every service like I know how. Just a ship without a sail. I'm lost without your help. About my will, it's all about what you want. Family used to be first, things getting worse in my home. My brother is hurt, we need a word, it's too far gone. I need a lifeline right now. 911 won't do. My back's against the wall now. Done all that I could do. I prayed every prayer, went to every service like I know how. Just a ship without a sail. I'm lost without you.
Help now, see, I feel left out, I can't tell my right from my left now. But my mama's crying cause my daddy's dying. He got pains all in his chest now. My daughter's having these nightmares. I might be wrong, but I'm right here, yeah. I'm trying to hold on when my hands hurt or the ropes out. Cause when life fights, it don't fight fair. So I'm leaning all on these ropes now. And I got hope, but it's low now. So I'm leaning all on these quotes now. Like never leave me, won't forsake me. If you don't help me, I don't make it.
Yeah.
Amen. I need your help. Amen. Amen. I need your help. Isn't it a wonderful, wonderful day today? It's just knowing that we have peace within God. Amen. Amen. Even when things get a little rowdy in your life, all you can do is turn to God and pray to Him and talk to Him. And then before you know it, all that stuff that you got on your mind just go away. Amen. Or a simple phone call from a good friend or a good sister, a brother that call you up just to check on you, see how you're doing. Don't that just make your day? Amen. Every once in a while, we have something. I'm not saying we should have something every single day, but every once in a while, we do have a little loneliness. Every once in a while, we have stuff on our plate, but we shouldn't look to have something every single day of the year, and year after year, we got the same old stuff. No, something should be different each and every day. Something, amen, in our life should be different. Hallelujah. Amen. God gives us newness every day. We wake up with a smile on our face. Amen. We just thank and praise God for it. I love you with the love of the Lord. God is good, and He's good all the time. Amen. Amen. If y'all don't have anything to do, amen, I just want to remind you that Faith Walkers International have Founders Day anniversary. Will be December the 11th and the 18th. And each service will be at 4 o'clock, and it's at 211 Dogwood Street, Franklinton, North Carolina, in the smaller building at the Franklin County BTU. And so we want to let you know that. And also, if you don't have a place to go worship on Sunday, or if you just would like to come and visit and worship with us, Healing Word Ministries will have services at 11 o'clock, and the address is 211 South Bickett Boulevard, Lewisburg, North Carolina, 27549. And we just want to pray, and we just want to uplift the name of Jesus, and we want to give a word from God. In such a time as this, we see things is going so crazy, and this county definitely need a reviving, a spiritual awakening. Amen. Because we know there's a lot of strongholds in this county. I mean, a lot of strongholds in this county. People are just being shackled down in prison in their minds and their spirits. And we just want to be a church of deliverance, a church where people could come in and get healing. And regardless of what you got in, got on your mind or whatever you've done, we want to bring it to the altar. We want to let the word, and the word will heal us. Amen. The word came that the word would heal us. Hallelujah. And that's what we believe on. That's what we founded on, the word of God. Amen. We ain't gonna deter from the word of God. And we ain't trying to go out here and sham people up. We're not trying to be a traditional church. We trying to follow the Spirit of God. And however He direct us, amen, that's the way we should go. Hallelujah. Whatever the scripture say, that's what we should line up with. Amen. So we want to just love on people. Amen. We don't come in any shape, form, or fashion. But we come just bring the word of God and just having that Christ-like love. And that's what we should be doing. And that's what we about. So we want to let you know, if you don't have a place to go on Sunday, come on down and worship with us. You are invited. Amen. We'll welcome you on welcome hinges. Amen. That's 211 South Bickett Boulevard, Lewisburg, North Carolina 27549, right beside the KFC in the small white building between that and the tattoo place. So, amen. We just thank God for that, and we'll be back with more. Stay tuned.
Morning, I was feeling kind of down, cause I went to bed with a problem, a solution could not be found. I thought that I could run away, but then it smacked me in my face. I was hoping it would stop, but it did not. See, if I'm gonna have to deal with this, God, You must take control of this, cause I have no more tears to fall. My pillow and sheets done soaked in mold. I get down on my knees to pray, but this thorn in my side won't go away. I am drained and I'm so weak. God, I know You're listening to me.
I know You hear me.
Even though
I know You hear me,
I can't see.
I know You hear me. I know You hear me when I pray.
And even though
I know I
get a little
me.
Weary,
I know You hear me. I know You hear me when I pray.
For those out there who may question God, you may feel like you're all alone. And
supposed to do? Which way should I choose? If I go left, what's right? See, I'm just making ends meet. Barely got enough to feed my family. And we ain't got a steak on the grill, but a dining room table full of bills. As I sit here to go through, I see the repos coming soon. Bad news I seem to earn. I ask you, God, when's my turn?
I know you hear me.
Can you hear me?
I know you hear me.
Can you feel
me?
Heaven is my goal. Yeah.
Put on my long white robe. Amen. Yes, sir. I love playing the best gospel, the best praise music around. And you've been listening to the TMA Radio Show, broadcasting worldwide. And we want to thank you and your family for continuing to listen in on this broadcast. Amen. Tomorrow night is Tuesday night. And normally we used to have Sports Minutes on Tuesday, but I lost my commentator, my sports analyst, you know, due to his job work. And so I just was hoping that we could get him back on, and we hope maybe there's a chance that we can start back up, but we missed him so much this season of football. And just a great mind of sports. But we just thank and praise God. The show continue to goes on. And we continue to have listeners and people tuning in. And I'm just so excited about it. So don't forget, amen, if you don't have a place to go, Faith Walkers International Founders Day Anniversary, December the 11th, December the 18th. They've already had it December the 4th. And each service is at 4 p.m. And it's at 211 Dogwood Street, Franklinton, North Carolina. And that's at the BTU, Franklin County BTU site, and is at the smaller building on the property. And so if you don't have anything to do at 4 o'clock on December the 11th and the 18th, go out and hear a word from God. And also, if you don't have a place to worship, or if you just want to come and just visit in and see, amen, what thus saith the Lord, amen, that it applies to your life, come out to Healing Word Ministries each and every Sunday at 11 o'clock. At 211 South Bickett Boulevard, Lewisburg, North Carolina, 27549. And we just thank God for what he's doing already, because even when it don't look like it, he's already working things out. All we got to do is just let his will be done and get ourselves out the way. And we can't worry about who said they was coming and didn't come, who didn't show up. We just continue to preach it. If it ain't but one person there, we'll preach. Amen. Amen. We're going to preach like never before, because God is that great of a God. Amen. And his word is so good, like honey going down our throat. Amen. So it's 11 o'clock, 211 South Bickett Boulevard, right, Lewisburg, right beside the KFC in Lewisburg. I love you with the love of the Lord. Thank you for tuning in tonight. God bless each and every one of you. And we are working on some things coming up in the new year. Amen. I'm so excited. And also, we are working on having a New Year's service. All right, so we are looking to having a New Year's service, and we're going to be trying to get that together, and we're going to get information out for you so you can come out and have just a good time. And we're going to be trying to get that information out to you as soon as possible. Amen. We love you here on the TMA Radio Show, and we want you to have a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful night. And again, we leave you with this, one of our favorite songs during this season. I tell you, them brothers be blowing. And y'all know what it is. I love it. I love it. I love harmony. And them brothers be harmonizing. Because I tell you right now, I love music. But I'm telling you, when you can sing without music, make your voice music. Oh, my goodness. So, so wonderful. So wonderful. I love you. Have a good night.
Was the night before Christmas, and all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse.
In my mind, what I Temptations.